Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how a pager works. Well, if you were born before 1990, this video is really not for you. The whole intention was, the other day, a kid actually came up to me and said, "What is that?" Seeing this on my hip, I told him it's a pager. He had no idea what it was. And by kid, I mean this guy's like 20 years old. He didn't know what a pager was. He didn't know how it worked. I said, "All right." So I showed him. And he was utterly impressed. He said, "So that's what there was before cell phones." Yeah, that's what there was before cell phones, kid. And they worked fantastic. I still carry a pager. Why? Well, I'm just kind of used to it. I've always had a pager for my work, and I never really stopped. So anyway, before the service actually finally completely goes away, I thought now would be a good time to just go ahead and show how a pager works. Someday, these may not work anymore. So I figured I'd preserve that. So, if you were born after 1990, this is probably going to be helpful to you. So the first thing you notice about this pager, Motorola, it's got a belt clip, which is removable. Shows the time. Currently, I have no pages. In the background, you can hear a receiver running. That receiver is actually an SDR that I'm using so that you can hear the paging frequency. Right there. So we're tuned in to the frequency that this pager is listening for. There's paging transmitters located on hilltops all around, and they run high power. Unlike cell phones, you don't need a million sites to operate pagers. It only takes a very few, but those sites are very high powered. Now, by high power, I mean we're talking a few hundred watts to a couple of kilowatts, as opposed to cell phones usually using somewhere around 600 milliwatts or something. So anyway, the pager is a receive-only device. It does not transmit. It only receives. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how it works. I'm going to dial my pager, and then I'm going to hold the phone up to the speaker so you can hear what the paging system sounds like when you call into it. So here we go.
Please leave your message after the tone followed by the pound key.
So you just go like this, I'll put some numbers in.
Thank you for calling American Messaging. Goodbye.
That's it. And then wait for your pager to go off. And you'll hear the transmission come through the receiver, and then the pager will respond. Nope, it wasn't in that batch. We have to wait for the next batch. Waiting to get a lot of pages together to send a bunch together as a batch. You don't want to... There we go. So now the pager's going off. I can shut it up by pressing this button. And then when I check the page, there's the numbers I put in on the phone. You put in a phone number usually, and then somebody calls you back. I have the option now of holding that, or I can... That's the time that it came in. Now if I want to delete the pages, I can just double... I don't know. Maybe I can't. Okay. Well, anyway. Oh, that's right. It's this one. There we go. Erase all. Yes. So now, again, no pages. Okay. Now if I wanted to leave a voicemail instead of leaving my phone number, I would just talk into the phone, and then the pager would go off with my pager number, and then that tells me I just call into the voicemail system to retrieve my messages. So it works either way. Either put in your phone number and it comes up on the display, or you leave a voicemail. Now, the other neat thing about pagers is the battery life. A cell phone, even one of these cell phones, the battery's good for, 4 days or something. Your typical iPhone, Galaxy, whatever, what do you get, a day out of it? Maybe. Pagers go for about 3 or 4 months on a battery. And you don't even have to recharge them. Check it out. The pager uses AA alkaline batteries, or some of them use AAA batteries. So you just unlock the battery case, slide this little door, and out comes the battery. So a typical AA battery lasts, like I say, about 3 or 4 months. Now, the neat thing is when the battery gets low, the screen will actually say low cell, and it tells you that it's time to replace the battery. But the pager keeps working. So the pagers still work for another week or two. I don't know, sometimes a little over 2 weeks with a low battery. Utterly amazing. These things were fantastic. People forget sometimes. They think that, well, new is better. Well, new isn't always better. Pagers worked. They worked great. They were fantastic for carrying around. I mean, you could take them on an airplane or anything because it doesn't transmit. It receives only. And they're not traceable. Unlike a cell phone, people can tell where you are every minute of every day, which is why pagers were really popular with drug dealers because you couldn't tell where they were. So anyway, long story short, that's how pagers work. They were absolutely the best thing going for the longest time until cell phones finally became cheap enough. But I still carry a pager. I don't know. I'm kind of old school that way. But I'll probably never change until they shut it off and pry it out of my cold, dead, clammy hands. I'll see you next time.